Good evening, and welcome to the graduation ceremony for the Forest Hills High School Class of 2020. This is the 54th graduating class in the history of the Forest Hills School District, and it is without a doubt the most unique ceremony we have experienced. Even though we could not celebrate a live ceremony at Mount Aloysius this year, this class deserves the recognition and fanfare the same as every other graduating class before it. And now, without further ado, the Forest Hills High School graduating class of 2020.
Vision of the one I see, a million dreams is all. tomorrow as we say goodbye to yesterday. A chapter ending, but the story's only just begun. A page is turning for everyone. So I'm moving on, letting go, holding on to tomorrow. I've always got the memories while I'm finding out who I'm gonna be. We might be apart, but I hope you always know you'll be with me wherever I go. Wherever I
said, so built for mama said, don't give up, it's a little complicated. All tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting. They say it's all been done, but they haven't seen the best of me. So I got one more run, and it's gonna be a sight to see.
Still there, our flag was there.
Oh, say, does that song
star-spangled banner yet wave. O'er the land of the free, and the home of the brave. Through our trust for everyone to see. We'll cherish all our chosen goals, no matter what fate wears. In victory or in defeat, we're true to for us
Before I begin, I would like to thank the hardworking staff and teachers at Forest Hills for making the graduation possible. You've always been there for us, even through the hardest of times. On behalf of the class of 2020, I'd like to take a moment to thank you all for helping us navigate through these uncertain times. It's with your support that we have been able to make the most of our situation. I would now like to welcome everyone who is viewing this video, teachers, parents, grandparents, family, and most importantly, students. I know it's strange not having an in-person graduation. A lot of us have been waiting for our moment to walk across the stage in front of all of our family members and classmates. We can choose to stay upset about it, or we can look at the positive side of things. Our graduation is going to be much more memorable than any other senior class. If you were to talk to anyone who has already graduated about their high school career, they would probably say, "What a ride we've been through." I'm sure all of those senior classes felt that they really did have a wild ride through high school, but I'm pretty sure our senior year takes the cake. I mean, who needs a senior skip day? Not us, that's lame. We had a senior skip month and counting. We are definitely unique. How many other senior classes can say that they remember the 21st night of September as their homecoming and their last day of school as Friday the 13th? Not only that, but I know that there aren't many other seniors who got to be the first class to spend 4 years in a brand new school. I definitely know the class of 2019 wishes they were in our shoes because we actually got to have our Gettysburg trip. And the class of 2021 is jealous too. They didn't get to have their ninth grade Kennywood trip. Our class had the opportunity to see the nation's capital and tour some of the world's greatest museums. We were able to not only have a prom, but an after prom year after year. Sure, we occasionally had to deal with things we didn't enjoy, like a bad lunch or a DJ with unusual taste in music, but all things considered, we had a good run. Even with everything that's going on now, I think we've been pretty lucky to experience what we have. I mention all of this because I want us to really just think about what's happening right now. Without the usual craziness that precedes graduation, many of us don't feel ready to be done with high school, but that's what graduation is. It's the end of our high school adventure. It's time to go off to college or start our careers. It's a turning point in our lives. We are now moving on to the next chapter. Some of us won't ever see each other again. How strange is that? Many of us are leaving now with one plan, but we might come back one day with an entirely different one. We might not think about any of that right now because we feel like our graduation fell by the wayside. But what I hope each of us remembers is that even if it feels like we're being overshadowed, we are still going through one of the most important parts of our lives. People may say to us, "You'll miss high school," and maybe we don't want to hear that. We're all ready to move on to whatever comes next and are too busy planning ahead to look back and miss the same thing that we've been working so hard to escape. We can never miss it, right? Honestly, I don't think we'll miss all of it. We probably won't miss the tests or the presentations or that class you didn't want to take, or the breakfast for lunch. But maybe, just maybe, you'll smile when you think of that kid in your class who stuck pencils in the ceiling. Maybe you'll remember that teacher who almost seared off his eyebrows. And maybe you'll laugh when you see your old yearbook picture. Maybe you'll tell your kids about your substitute teacher who was also a professional wrestler. You might think back on how good the Ranger sub tasted, or you might think about how much you missed playing your sport. Maybe you realize you wish you could sing on stage one last time. Maybe you'll think I miss high school. We're moving on now, and it's a fact. But when we move on, maybe it's okay to look back. Don't get me wrong, I want each and every one of us to move on to our next stage of life. I just also want us to look back and think about all of the people we've met, the experiences we've had, and the memories we've made over the years and how they've shaped us. As this speech comes to an end, just remember, this is also the end of high school. It's also just the beginning of a new adventure full of new people and experiences. I hope everyone can look back and find some memory, no matter how small, and be happy. I know that our class will be one of the most successful classes to ever come out of Forest Hills, and that our class will always remain close. Now there is nothing left to say except thank you, Forest Hills, for an unforgettable 13 years. I hope to see you all again someday.
Members of the Board of Education, colleagues in the administration, distinguished members of the faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2020. This day marks an end of an era in your young life. Graduation is a door which one side opens to a childhood quest, yet on the other side opens to a life of opportunity, potential, and incredible wonder. Parents, you should be extremely proud of your child's accomplishments. This sacred Psalm event represents a snapshot of the legacy that you're leaving behind. I'd like to tell you a little bit about this class. The students reported being awarded over $1.2 million in scholarships from outside sources. So far, 15 students will attend a two-year tech school. 15 students will attend a two-year university. 49 students will attend a four-year university, and 7 will serve our country in the armed forces. Congratulations on the life decisions that you have already made. I am certain your humble upbringing in this community will serve you well as you pursue your dreams and passions. Over the past several months, I've spent time thinking about the time that we've missed due to the COVID-19 pandemic. During that time, I came to appreciate the resiliency and poise of the class of 2020 has demonstrated. In some cases, the students were much more accepting of the situation than the staff, parents, and community. It's a mark of true leadership to be patient and understanding when facing a crucial moment in your life. The class of 2020 clearly displayed their ability to lead, handle adversity, and overcome challenges. During this time, I also had the privilege of sharing an intimate experience with each graduate and their families during the personalized graduation taping sessions. This experience humbled me and taught me the importance of high school graduation and how family, friends, time, and loss impact each of us. To highlight these examples, I will use a few analogies from my past Christmas experiences. Family. I have to admit, at times during Christmas, both family and friends thought the Lehman home bordered on dysfunction. During one Christmas, my dad decided we would hang a freshly cut Christmas tree upside down from the ceiling. I wish we had cell phones with video capability to capture the tree hanging experience. Nonetheless, moments like this make memories that last over several lifetimes. Sometimes we take family and time spent with family for granted. It was very evident how precious family is to all the graduates. It was very humbling to see the pride and love that was exuded by all the family members. As you move from Forest Hills, do not forget where you came from and all who helped you get to this moment. Even though all families have their moments, your family is the one element in life who will always be there for you. Always make time for your family. Never do anything which will disrespect your family name. And remember how important it is to preserve a lasting legacy within your family. Time. One Christmas, as our family strung lights on the family tree, it was apparent we did not have enough color bulbs for the light sets. Being that we didn't have much money at the time, my grandfather and I decided to take things in our own hands. Pap had a collection of nightlight bulbs, and we decided to spray paint some of the bulbs with leftover spray paint. This was a genius idea, until the bulbs nearly ignited on the Christmas tree. At the time, this was not a laughing matter. But that memory from over 40 years ago still makes me smile when we decorate our tree. I would do anything to spend some time with Pat. Time appears to pass by at double speed. I would bet many of you can hardly believe that your baby is about to graduate. Time is precious, and as a parent, each moment with family, friends, and these graduates is important. Never take the time which you are given for granted. Make the most of every moment and every day that you're given. Make sure you spend your best moments with the people who mean the most to you. Loss. Christmas morning was always a crazy time at the Lehman home. My brother would position himself at the top of the steps, and when my parents gave him the okay, he would slide down the steps on his bottom at breakneck speed. To this day, I do not know how he did not get hurt doing that stunt. My sister was always the last person up because she knew what was in the packages. You see, my sister was a master unwrapper and rewrapper. She would sneak up and unwrap and rewrap all the presents, leaving no surprise. I am much more of a traditionalist. To this day, I even save my mailed birthday cards and only open them on my actual birthday. I love the anticipation and excitement. Just like my sister losing the surprise and excitement of Christmas morning, it's true that you experienced several losses during your senior year. However, it's also true that each of you battled through those losses and accomplished much more than any of us thought was possible. In your journey, don't be afraid to make some mistakes. Always expect to win. Outlive your darkest days. Go with your Ranger upbringing, and you will overcome adversity. I'd like to thank the class of 2020 for allowing me to be part of your life. Parents, extended family members, thank you for your support and for allowing us the opportunity to have an impact on your child's development. Thank you for all you have done for the learning community. Graduates, I'm very optimistic to watch you grow and become productive and successful adults. Dream big dreams and work hard to reach those dreams. Don't forget your foundation and keep Forest Hills in your hearts. Know and be proud that you're a Ranger. Make the best moments you can. Best wishes.
When you are younger, you wish you're older, and when you're older, you wish for time to turn around. Don't let your wonder turn into closure. When you get older, when you get older. I was walking down 57th Street to our park with the same old song in my same old heart, making plans I'm gonna do when I get older. Past the gray-haired man and I found his eyes, and like he knew my thoughts and he read my mind, saying life is gonna find you when it goes down. But my feet stopped short and I turned my head to lead into every side. Turn into closure.
Well, I'd love to stand here and say all the normal, cheesy graduation things. I'd love to tell you that we made the most of our last few months, and that our last prom was perfect, our senior prank was one for the books, and our last day of school was a day we'll never forget. But when your last day of high school ends up being a random Friday in March, you miss out on getting to give that kind of graduation speech. So, yes, we never got to have our senior prom and spend $200 on that dress we were just dying to buy. We never got to stay up all hours of the night at our senior after prom, racing our friends in the giant bouncy castle. The drama kids didn't get to feel the magic of opening night one last time. The musicians missed out on their final concerts, some of them even missing out on their favorite events of the year, PMEA festivals. The baseball players didn't get their final home runs, the softball girls didn't get to run the bases after their winning game. The track kids didn't get to do their final laps or jumps, and the girls' basketball team never got the chance to win their well-deserved championship. The Frenzy kids were supposed to go to Chicago for the national competition, and the drama kids to New York City. And worst of all, we aren't even having a typical graduation ceremony. And yeah, we could focus on all the things that we were looking forward to and had to miss, like senior skip day, our senior prank, and getting out of school weeks before the underclassmen. Or we can choose to look back at all of the amazing things our class has done in the past 4 years of school here. That's what I've chosen to do, and I hope you will too. For among our class sits the 2018-2019 Cambria County Dairy Princess, the 2019 second runner-up of Cambria County's Outstanding Young Women Scholarship Program, and Miss Dance of Pennsylvania 2020. Two of our classmates hold the most prestigious awards for Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts, the Gold Award and the Eagle Scout Award. We have students who have been nominated for Isaac's Awards, several who have gone to state band and chorus festivals, and one even to All East and National Chorus. Last year, four students in our class went to National Forensics in Wisconsin, and many have placed in state and regional forensic competitions. The robotics team even made it to Worlds. How awesome is that? On the sports side of things, our class has gone to states for cheerleading, twice in cross country, and three times for track. We've gotten many District 6 titles, including basketball, track, and cross country. We've had so many accomplishments, and I'm sure I haven't even mentioned them all. And that's all just in 4 years. Imagine what we can do in 10 or 20. Our class is full of some of the most talented and intelligent people that I have ever met, and I can honestly say that we are going to go on to do amazing things. Even though we didn't get to finish our last 3 months of high school, we have already done so much and have created so many incredible memories together. I will miss all of you more than you know, and I want to thank you all for allowing me to be part of such a fantastic class. A class that is extremely dedicated to everything they do, whether that be sports, the arts, or academics. A class that always stands up for what they believe in and doesn't let anyone stop them from achieving their dreams. And most importantly, a class that supports one another and never fails to lift each other up. When we think back on high school in the future, I don't think that we will remember the anger and frustration that came with missing the last few months of school, but rather the small things, like laughing with friends while you're walking down the hall, or complaining about a certain lunch, teacher, or class. We're going to remember the kind of things that accompany the camaraderie that only forms after knowing each other for 13 years. So when we have our first class reunion in 10 or however many years, know that it will be all the more special after living through this pandemic. The last time that we spent together as a class will not have been our graduation, like the classes before us, but rather an unassuming Friday in the middle of March. So even though it can be hard sometimes to look at this situation in a positive light, though you may feel like the final memories you were promised have slipped through your fingers, and though you think that you never got the closure of ending your high school years with the friends that have been by your side since kindergarten, know that each and every one of you has made an impression on this school. An impression that no matter what life throws your way, whether it be another pandemic or simply a bad day, will never be taken away from you. We've done some pretty outstanding things in our short lifetimes, and we are a part of history. I feel as though we should take this abrupt ending as an opportunity to learn. I mean, that's what high school's all about, right? Mrs. Livermore always tells the drama kids that you never know when your last time on stage will be. I always ignored this statement because I thought I knew exactly when it would be, after my spring play. Well, I was wrong, and I wish I would have listened to her. The statement doesn't only apply to theater, though, but as to life as a whole. You never know when your last sports game is going to be, your last concert, your last bus ride, or even your last day of high school. So please, don't waste a single day, and don't make the same mistake I did. Spend every day doing the things you love, or even hate, as though it is the last time, because you never know when it will be. I cannot wait to see what is in store for each and every one of you, so do what you love, and good luck.
Let me just start by saying, Phew. We really got a special ending to our high school career, huh? But if you think about it this way, what other class gets to say they graduated high school during a full-on pandemic? Over the last 4 years here, we have learned quite a lot. Mr. Orbarski has taught us that he is the best star drawer and that none of us could ever come close. Mr. Golden has shown us Extra, the best Spanish sitcom there is. Only my Spanish 4 pals will get that one. In eighth grade, Mr. Cosmack taught us all the best song ever. I know you all know what I'm getting at here. Photosynthesis? Mr. Grove has taught us that there is a tie for every occasion. Shout out Mr. Grove, you really do have the best ties. Mr. Christ taught us that math can be sexy. Mr. Evans taught us that the equivalent to Israel and Palestine is a dumpster fire. And depending on who you had, Mrs. McCloskey and Mr. Madison taught us one of the most important things that we will ever learn. The mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. Point is, we've learned some valuable information here at Forest Hills. Now, I know that many of you have never been involved in drama club, but I think there is something to be said about how similar the experiences of theater are to those of life. I think we've all heard the quote from Shakespeare saying, "All the world's a stage." And now more than ever, I realize exactly what he meant by that. I think all of my drama family will vouch for me when I say the experiences that we've had in theater have shaped each and every one of us into the people that we are today. And these experiences are universal. They will carry out through the rest of our lives, even if they come in different packages. I know for a fact that each and every one of us has felt nervous before. I personally am a nervous wreck half the time, so I get it. This can be likened to the nerves of an audition, a musical audition, a sports tryout, an interview, a class presentation, whatever. You know that feeling. When your palms are sweaty and your heart starts racing and you feel like you might just run out. It's kind of like how I'm feeling right now, actually. But this feeling of nervousness is one of the most universal feelings in the world. The nerves of an audition can relate to the nerves that you may be feeling right now, watching you and your classmates and best friends of 13 years graduate. Crazy, huh? Okay, so you know that feeling when you walk into the building on the first day of school? You see all of your classmates and you just prepare yourself for what the school year is about to bring. All these feelings equal exactly what it is like to attend the first read-through of a theater production. You meet your fellow castmates, you find out what your show will be about, you figure out which character you'll be playing. Everyone is so overwhelmed and nervous, yet incredibly hopeful of the new things to come. And similar to this, every new chapter of your life will bring about new people to meet, new experiences, and a new role for you to play. This is where things are fresh, things are new. And you can have the same nerves as before, but you're still hopeful. But that hope and optimism of the first read-through will fade, just like the excitement of the first week of school or a job gives way to reality. And this transition requires dedication. I know that most, if not all, of us hate waking up early. I was so thankful when I could finally drive to school and get that extra sleep in. Even though it was usually only like 15 minutes more, I think we all know the complete power of those extra 15 minutes. This struggle to peel yourself off your bed in the morning is the same as the struggles as an early rehearsal. Though we might have felt like total zombies in the morning, I feel like these are the rehearsals where we really did get the most accomplished. And I think this will carry on through the rest of our lives. Early bird gets the worm, right? Though theater was usually super fun, there were definitely times when it was not. Drama kids know what it's like to see Storm mad. And she didn't ever really yell at us, but she was still scary, you know? So just like in theater, there are times in your life where you will have to stay disciplined. And though no one likes to be disciplined, when you really focus on what you need to do, just a little bit, there's always room for some fun. These sacrifices will change the outcome of your performance, in theater and in life, for the better. And when you're disciplined and work hard, you will now get to the payoff, the magic of opening night. There's nothing quite like it. All drama kids pity those who have never felt this magic and envy our younger castmates who get to experience it for the first time. For those of you who don't know this feeling, just think about the magic that you may be feeling right now, graduating. The magic you feel starting the next chapter. It's hard to explain, so imagine the greatest thing that has ever happened in your life. Got it? Now take that, times 1,000. That's opening night magic for you. Now on to one of the most powerful yet difficult aspects of theater, putting a character to rest when the show ends. Saying goodbye to something that feels like a part of you. However, you get to lay that character to rest knowing that you did it justice, knowing that you poured your heart and soul into every performance. And I hope that is all what you all feel for yourselves right now, ending your high school career and having a new beginning. As of right now, most of us have had the main role of high school student for quite some time. But as we graduate, we are slowly putting that role to rest. Just like in theater, this role will be a part of us forever. We take what we learned in the past and apply it to future roles. All of our hard years of work, and dedication have shaped us into who we are today. It has changed the way that we approach our next roles, our next performances. And finally, something that should never go unnoticed in theater or life, the power of the audience, the people cheering you on. In drama club, sometimes it took until the opening night audience to get us into gear, at the dismay of all of our directors. But just knowing that there are people supporting you can make all the difference. In life, you will always have some sort of audience, whether it be your parents, grandparents, teachers, bosses, friends, or even strangers. We all know the power of kind words and support, and the audience gives you just that. Without this, none of us would be where we are today. So thank you to our audience for being an endless support system for all these years. Now, if there's anything you take away from this speech, I want it to be this one last thing, something that STOM has taught drama kids for years, and that is to savor the moment. Take it all in. This may just be the most important life lesson that I've learned during my time here at Forest Hills, and it has changed me, for good. If you apply this simple three-word phrase to your life, you will start noticing the little things, because sometimes the little things in life are the most powerful. Thank you guys for being the best class ever, and I wish you all nothing but the best. But just remember, whether you experience dramatic highs or just the same old ordinary days, remember to sit back for a moment. Take it all in. Go kick some butt out there, Rangers. I love you guys. Thank you.
Good evening, class of 2020. What we have experienced over the past several months in our school, our country, and our world have been nothing but historic. And you have had a front row seat. My dad used to tell me how the snow was as tall as the telephone poles, and he walked to school uphill, both ways, of course, and the one-way trip was 5 miles. Imagine the stories you'll be able to tell your children, exaggerated or otherwise, about what we have experienced. No social gatherings, wearing masks, and searching everywhere for toilet paper. I can only imagine what these stories will sound like 30 years from now. When I think of the class of 2020, I always reflect on the leadership qualities you as individuals and as a group have displayed. One of my favorite authors is John Maxwell. Maxwell is a world-renowned expert on leadership. One of his most famous quotes is, "Everything rises and falls on leadership." Now think about this. Everything rises or falls on leadership. This statement is so true. Good leadership gets everything moving in a positive direction, whereas a poor leader can have a lasting negative effect on an organization. You have always shown the qualities of a good, positive leader. The last 3 months have been a perfect way for you to put your leadership qualities front and center. So what are some of the qualities of an effective leader? The ability to adapt. Staying positive. Someone who is a good, flexible communicator. And finally, someone who really cares about others. I know all of you will continue to display these qualities throughout your lives. The world is always in need of positive, effective leaders. Leadership is a timeless quality that spans all generations and circumstances. COVID-19 has challenged your leadership qualities, and you all passed with flying colors. Those colors just happen to be green and gold. I am proud to say that I have been able to be your principal over the last several years. We will be forever connected as you continue through life's journey. And as you face challenges and transitions, keep an attitude of confidence and determination, and you will be able to succeed no matter what life throws at you. Class of 2020, I'm very proud of you. I'll miss you. And I thank you for being the best Forest Hills Ranger you could be. You've made us all very proud. Good luck, and God bless. And now, on with the program. At this time, we are proud to present the Forest Hills Class of 2020 as they receive their diplomas.
Hunter Potter. Brianna Lohr. Gage Jones. Alexis Gibbons. Lily Conkle. Nathaniel Harris. Emily Units. Kirsten Emmerich. Madison Stombaugh. Gary Hostetler. Jacob John Rock. Michael Bassbinder. Caitlin Hamza. Madison Gerzelski. Kelsey Nicole Josephson. Lucas Edward Minor. Katie Rose Lamer. Casey Rayanne Williams. Rosalie Marie DiPolo. Skylar Marie Hostetler. Dominic Ryan Hughes. Corey Joseph Colbert. Logan Samuel Sarlewis. Daniel Velasquez. John Kapach. Natalia Tino. Casey Berdomas. Ariel Zeverich. Haley Christ. Carly Schaefer. Alexis Noon. Ashley Pauly. Shannon Louise Schaefer. Joseph Parch. Hemming. Joshua Ryan Horner. Madison Shea Easterbrook. Tony Tack. Isaac Hogger. Rebecca Grace Williamson. Andrew Conrad. Samuel Mario Doika. Grace Ann Edsel. Bailey Ann Snedden. Ashlyn Hamara. Olivia Hamara. Garrett Connor. Jacob Daniel Russell. Thomas Matthew Hawkinsmith. Corinne Olivia Hill. Abigail Rose Cease. Jordana Mac Ickes. Caitlin Sislovitz. Tyler Christopher Woomer. Chance Alexander Kometz. Trevor Gordon. Mia Pascarella. Julie Ann Douglas. Cameron Zevrich. Paige Handel. Ethan Blau. Michaela Lorraine Drobnik. Diane Nicole Boyle. Richard Ashlock. Luke Jeremy Rebar. McKenna Chestnutwood. Seth Christopher Richardson. Tyler Miller. Richard Thomas Golden III. Jonathan Brent McCall. Damian Schrift. Travis Watkins. Elias Klein. Benjamin Joseph Schrader. Sydney Lane McCormick. Laura Alexandra Lundberg. Lacey Adele Greathouse. Caitlin Marie Rusnak. Megan Marie Rusnak.
Hayden Michael Stoller. William Lowe Ayers. David Nastas. Maria Hope Carosi. Cody St. Clair. Kiana Marie Little. Logan Michael Mock. Cheyenne Marie Thomas.
Jonathan Rainier. Aiden Neeson. Zachary Andrew Vitko. Bryson Rerick. Megan Elizabeth Miller. Colton McCombie. Peyton Abigail Swope. Destiny Wallace. Thank you. Mackenzie Maranka. Jacob Matthew Delic. Autumn Gail Holdsworth. Robbie Civi. Hannah Elizabeth Michaels. Kendall Lynn Bukovich. Hayden Romano. Kylie Ann Shaw. Ashley Nicole Myers. Cody Christopher Lance. Thank you.
Kaylee Ann Krynock. Haley Lynn Van Mail.
Luke Dougherty. Shannon Marie Elgin. Caitlin Rose Cameron. Elizabeth Marie Zidell. Michaela Eileen Miller. Noah Michael Webb. Kyle Allen Miller. Alyssa Love Stropko. Donovan John Faith. Caleb Sorchilla. Donovan John Faith. Caleb Sorchilla. Bailey Frampton. Gabriel Howe Bayock. Christian Sacco.
Seniors, at this time, please put on your caps. Now, move your tassels from right to left. By the power vested in me as the principal of the Forest Hills High School, I am pleased to state that these students have fulfilled the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Pennsylvania Department of Education and the Forest Hills School District. Congratulations, seniors.